Let's install the AltRider luggage rack on our Honda CRF450L. Also works with the RL. They're basically the same bike. This is a great rack to add some utility to your dual sport, and hey, I think it's a great looking rack. In your kit, you'll receive the rack itself, either black or silver, made from 3/16 inch aluminum with coined or rounded edges to ensure your straps or gear won't fray over time. The left and right bracket, four M8 flatheads, along with their corresponding washers and nylon nuts to attach the rack to the brackets, two spacers and 55 millimeter long M8 fasteners and washers. These will replace the OEM fasteners at the back of the seat. Another two M8 fasteners that are 30 millimeters long with washers. These are two of the four fasteners that will attach underneath the fender to the subframe. And lastly, two M6 fasteners with washers that also go in under the fender. Tools needed: 10 and 12 millimeter socket, a 5 and 6 millimeter hex driver or Allen key, and then a ratchet and or driver. Start off by removing the two fasteners beneath the seat, one on each side with the 10 millimeter socket and ratchet. Then move underneath the fender where the rear bracket that holds the license plate is. Remove the two frontmost bolts with the 10 millimeter socket and ratchet. Next, the two rearmost bolts with the 10 millimeter socket and ratchet. The rear bracket with the license plate should come off. Our 450 has an aftermarket tail tidy on it, but if you have the factory setup, each of the fasteners will have a collar. Keep them as they'll be reused. The frontmost and rearmost collars are different, so be sure to keep track. Grab the left and right AltRider brackets. They attach like so, with the four fasteners going underneath the fender. Grab the two long 55mm M8s, two M8 washers, and the two spacers. Put the washers on and feed the fasteners through the brackets and then the spacers, so that it looks like this. Just get them hand tight for now. Do this to both sides. Underneath the fender, grab the two remaining M8 fasteners with washers. These will go into the rearmost holes. Place the factory collars on the AltRider brackets so that the collars are closest to the fender. Then line up the license plate bracket with the AltRider bracket, and the fastener will go through all three: license plate bracket, AltRider bracket, and then the collar. Get those two M8s hand tight. Lastly, grab the two M6 with washers so that the collars are closest to the fender, and start them into the forwardmost holes. Just keep all these hand tight so it'll make lining up the rack easy. It should look like this. Put the rack on and line it up with the holes. Grab the four remaining flatheads, washers, and nuts. One by one, drop the flathead through the rack and the bracket and feed a washer and nylon nut on. There's enough space between the fender and the top of the brackets to get your hands in there and get everything started. Once you have all four of your flatheads started, let's go back to the brackets and do our final tightening. The M8s below the seat can be tightened using a 6mm hex key with ratchet to 25 newton meters or 18 foot-pounds. The rearmost brackets underneath the fender can be tightened using a 6mm hex key with a ratchet to 25 newton meters or 18 foot-pounds as well. And the two towards the front tighten with the 5mm hex key and ratchet to 10 newton meters or 7 foot-pounds. And lastly, keep that 5mm hex key and ratchet, and then using the 13mm wrench, tighten down the four bolts attaching the rack to the brackets. Tighten them down to 10 newton meters or 7 foot-pounds. Be sure to do your final tightening on the nuts to minimize any chance of stripping. The nuts have more surface area. And that's it. You're ready to ride. If you've got any comments or questions, just reach out to us. We always love to hear from our customers.